Good morning, it's Pastor Jerry, and if you're watching this, you're an eagle between the ages of 10 and 12. Enjoy your class.
Good morning, Eagles. How are you today? How are you doing? How have you been? I haven't seen you guys in a long time and I'm really, really missing you. I know some of you have gone back to school and some of you are doing online schooling. How is it going? I hope everything is fine. And I don't know if she's still here, but somebody turned 13 on Friday. So maybe she's left and she's gone. But if you're still here, you know yourself. Happy birthday, Tessa. So, before we go into today's word, let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this wonderful, wonderful day. This is the second Sunday in February. We give you glory and praise that we are privileged to be part of this day, to see you, Father, Lord God, in the faces of your children, to know you, Father, Lord, we thank you. We give you glory, we give you praise. As we go into the word this morning, let us learn, let me learn. I would also like to learn, Father, Lord God, from you. Teach us, Father, Lord God, the way to behave, the way to be like you, that in all our thoughts, in our actions, in everything that we do, in the things that we say, we will be godly. They call the glory, Father, Lord. They call the glory for today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. So, Eagles, we have an exciting time today. I'm so blessed to be actually doing this lesson with you, because it's something that even I need to learn. Huh? We're going to learn together from God today. But first, we're going to do our music. We're going to dance. Have you got your dancing shoes on? Have you got the space around the house? So we're going to dance. We're going to have praise and worship. And after that, we're going to take our pledge. All of us are going to do our pledge. Then we'll do our memory verse before. Oh, so many things to do. Let's start.
Drugs for 10 years. Today is my second year being clean and free of them. Victory is my song.
Come on, somebody, lift up your sound of victory wherever you are. This is the sound of victory.
Grateful, yeah.
So, welcome back. How was that? Was that so much fun? Yes, I thought so. Okay, let's take... Oh, well, for today, we're still going to have our memory verse from Tessa. And I think from next week, we're going to need someone else because she's moving to... Yes, she's moving up to the 10th class. Okay, but here's Tessa.
I pledge as a city kid to behave as Jesus Christ would at all times, to listen to authority, to be bold and talk to everyone about Jesus Christ, to learn one memory verse a week, to respect and help others. Virtues of a city kid are honesty, respect, compassion, and responsibility.
Welcome back. Are you ready now? First, our memory verse today. Have you got your Bibles? You got your Bibles? Yes, 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 yes. Our memory verse today is taken from the book of Mark. Mark is in the New Testament, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. You know, it's Matthew, Mark. That's the second book in the New Testament. And we're going to read chapter 9, verses 33 to 37. Mark 9, verses 33 to 37. Have you got your Bibles? Okay, let's read. After they arrived at Capernaum and settled in a house, Jesus asked his disciples, "What were you discussing out on the road?" But they didn't answer, because they had been arguing about which of them was the greatest. He sat down and called the 12 disciples over to him and said, "Whoever wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else." Let me read that again. Whoever wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else. Then he put the little child among them. Taking the child in his arms, he said to them, "Anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf welcomes me. And anyone who welcomes me welcomes not me, but also my Father who sent me." Okay, is that a little bit confusing? Let's do it again. So let me read from 34, okay? Let me just start from the beginning. After they arrived at Capernaum and settled in a house, Jesus asked his disciples, "What were you discussing out on the road?" But they didn't answer because they had been arguing about which of them was the greatest. I guess they were a bit embarrassed now, hey? He sat down and called the 12 disciples over to him and said, "Whoever wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else." Then he put the little child among them. Taking the child in his arms, he said to them, "Anyone who welcomes a child like this on my behalf welcomes me, and anyone who welcomes me welcomes not only me, but also my Father who sent me." Is that a little bit confusing? Huh? If you want to be first, then you have to be last. What does that mean? If you want to be first, you have to be last. Jesus was simply telling us that, or telling his disciples and us as well, that if you want to be the first, like you want to be Jesus, you must be willing to serve. If you want to be a leader, for example, you must be willing to serve those that you are leading. You must be willing to do things for them as well. You cannot be puffed up and arrogant. "I'm the greatest. I'm the leader. So you're going to do what I have to, you're going to do whatever it is I tell you to do." No, that's not how Jesus led us. That's not what Jesus taught us by his behavior. And you remember when I was praying, I said, let us be godly in our behavior, in our speech, the words that come out of our mouth, and in our mind, okay, when we're thinking. Jesus led by example. He was not boastful. He was not arrogant. He was actually humble. And that's what we're going to learn in our Bible reading today, okay? So let's take our Bibles now, and we're going to read Matthew, which is the first book in the New Testament. So we're going to read Matthew 18, verses 1 to 5. Matthew 18, verses 1 to 5. Let's go. Open your Bible. Okay. Verses 1 to 5, Matthew 18. I still got my Bible with me. "About that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, 'Who is greatest in the kingdom of heaven?' Jesus called the little child to him and put the child among them. Then he said, I tell you the truth. Unless you turn from your sins and become like little children, you will never get to the kingdom of heaven. So anyone who becomes as humble as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven.'" Verse 5, "And anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf is welcoming me. Let's read that again. Jesus, about that time, the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" Jesus called the little child to him and put the child among them. Then he said, "I tell you," so this is verse 3, "I tell you the truth. Unless you turn from your sins and become like little children, you will never get into the kingdom of heaven. So anyone who becomes as humble as this little child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven." Now, I know some of you are going to say, "Well, good, I'm a child, so I'm already going to the kingdom of heaven." By God's grace, if you already have believed, if you've given your life to Jesus Christ, you believe that he's the Lord and Savior, and is the only Son of God, then you're already going to heaven, okay? But this is not what it's saying here. The disciples were saying, who is the greatest? Maybe they wanted to know who will be the first person in heaven after Jesus, or who's going to sit beside Jesus, or who did Jesus love, but they were saying, who is the greatest? Now, some of us, we are like that, okay? Maybe you do very well in school, or maybe you're the prefect in your class, and you puffed up, you know? You're very... the way you talk to your friends, you're almost rude. And sometimes you're even rude because you are the best. Or maybe you came first in class and you're always coming first and like, yes, I am the best person. I am the greatest in my class. I am the best in my grade. God doesn't want that. God doesn't want that at all. It says that we must be humble. That's what it's saying to us here. Whoever is as humble as a child, and you're already a child. I know you're already a child. Yes, but even then you must be humble. Children are not excluded from being humble. You cannot be arrogant in the way you think. You cannot be arrogant in the way you behave towards people. Maybe you're good at sports, not just what you say. Maybe you're good at sports and everybody wants you on their team. You know, maybe you're playing a friendly match and everybody wants you like, yeah, yes. Okay, I'm going to choose because I don't know if I want you guys today and I don't know if I want you guys today. So I'm going to choose who I want. That's being puffed up. That's being arrogant, okay? The ability that you have to do that sport, who gave it to you? God gave it to you. The ability, the intellect that you have to be able to be so smart in school, who gave it to you? God. So you cannot then become puffed up, or you should not. Don't let me say again. You should not, okay? If you've been doing that, you need to repent now, which means you need to stop it. And stop behaving like that. Be humble. If everybody wants you to be their friend, just say, it's okay. We can all be friends. Rather than, oh, I don't like you guys. I'm only going to be friends with those in the swimming club. No. Oh, I'm only going to be friends with those in the science, who are good at science. Because I'm good at science and I'm good at math. And so that's no, you don't do that. Okay. And if you do, then you have to stop. You shouldn't do that. Be humble in everything that you do. In what you say, in what you think. Jesus said, whoever welcomes a little child is welcoming him. So instead of being puffed up in what you know how to do, what should you do? Help those who are not able to. Help those who need just a little push, you know? Help them. If at home, you can help your siblings, even if they are older than you and you know something. I don't have any problem with that. I will ask anyone. If I know you know something better than me, I will ask you to help me. And you should be able to do that. It's not so, guess what? Auntie Demi doesn't know this kind of math. Auntie Demi doesn't know algebra. I'm not good at algebra. But does that make me less of a person? No. So if you know algebra and you can teach me, then I'll be very happy. Do you understand? But that doesn't mean you get puffed up because of that. You don't become arrogant because of that. You don't, I don't have the time to help you today. I'm so busy. Or say, you know, nasty things like, you're so dumb. You need to also go and learn it by yourself. I learned how to do it. That's not what God wants from us, okay? That's not what he wants. He says, whoever is going to be greatest. Remember in Mark 9, 33 to 37 that we read, that whoever is going to be first, must be what? Must be last. So we also said, whoever, you must be ready to be a servant to others. Okay. You cannot say you're a leader, for example, but you do not want to do anything that you're asking people to do. If you're asking people, for example, in class to pack away their books, to make sure that the class is tidy to get ready for your next class, for your next subject, but you are not willing to do any of that. You don't want to move the shelves. You don't want to tidy the tables. You don't want to help to make sure the class is clean, but you want others to do it. That's not leading by example. Huh? You also must be ready to be a servant. You must be ready to serve others and not say because I am the leader or I'm the oldest in this class or whatever it is. Okay. So let's remember this memory verse. Should we go over it again? It's Mark 9. Verses 33 to 37. I really like this. It says again, where I want you to remember is when you, 35. Let's read 35. He sat down, called the 12 disciples over to him and said, whoever wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else. Whoever wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else. And you know something that just occurred to me now. You know, when someone is asking you to do something and they're already doing it, say, oh, please help me make some sandwiches for those who are, just help me make some sandwiches. And they're already making the sandwiches. You know, you feel more like helping because they're not sitting down watching TV and say, oh, please help me make some sandwiches and bring it. You know what I mean? Then you feel more like doing it with them. They are leading by example. They are being leaders, but they're willing to also serve those who need to be served. Do you understand? So I want you to remember that in what you think, in what you do, in what you say. Be a servant so you can be first. Okay, if you look at it like that, I'm going to serve you so that I can be first. That's what Jesus wants us to do. Okay, until next time, bye for now.